he's not all that gone for me.
You know, when we're playing, I can still hear, like, the crinkle of his guitar. I can tell which direction he's going. I can hear the notes on the scale, all that kind of stuff. Somebody lives in your head and in your heart for that many years. It's not going to go away. It's not just going to, you know, it's not like you can turn it off just because somebody, you know, checked out. No, that doesn't happen, at least not for me. And not for anybody I've ever known, for that matter. So he's still very much there as far as I'm concerned.
Oh, Standing on the moon, I see a shadow on the sun. Standing on the moon, stars go fading one by one. I hear a cry of victory. Another of defeat. Well, I scrap some lullaby down some forgotten street. Forgotten street.
As As my friend pointed out, you have to go out of your mind to use your head. And that what I had been trained in was an ego structure, a conceptual structure that defined who I was and who everybody else was. Most people learn these structures and they're like huge mind nets that come out of your head. And you walk down the street and you're somebody. You say, you know who you are. You dress like somebody. Your face looks like somebody. Everything is somebody. Nuss. This is who I am. 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 This is who you are. This is who you are. You, everybody is reinforcing their structure of the universe over and over again. And they meet like two huge things meeting. This is who I am. This is who you are. And we enter in these conspiracies. I'll make believe you are who you think you are. If you make believe I am who I think I am. And we just kind of bump against each other like huge schmooze or something. Big mental mind nets that keep walking down the street. You can see them in everybody. I mean, everybody's busy being somebody. The problem with the intellect, however, is that it doesn't allow you to escape from dualism. That is, it always thinks about something. So it always takes an object. So as long as you identify with your thinking mind, you are always one thought away from where the action is. You're always thinking about it or looking at it. You're always in that one thought away from life. And you experience that you are cut off by being in your mind. And there is a quality that is starving in an individual that is locked in their mind. So when you move to another plane of consciousness, which is no longer controlled by your intellect, which is really a subsystem, and you move into the metasystem, what you feel at that moment is, subjectively in the universe, you feel like you are the universe, or you feel merged with it, or you feel fully in the moment, thick with the moment. And that richness is so fulfilling. It's interesting. It just is. You can be it. The minute you try to know it or experience it, you go back into dualism. But you can be the thickness of the moment.